been nice to be back. I had some problems with my hands, guys and gals, and I had to go away for a little while. So I'm back with a bunch of questions today. I've got a list of questions here from a whole bunch of people I'm going to try to get to today. It is Easter Sunday, waiting for the family to come over. And so I wanted to attack some things here, and I'm going to talk fast because I got a lot going here. So a bunch of people out have asked me how I get the tone and feel out of my amp now that I do, the Kemper being one of my amps. You know, if you've known me for the last 30 years or so, I've been trying to get away from tubes. Nothing seems to work as good as a tube when it comes to picking up the feeling of your playing, and we can go into some of that in another video. Let me explain to you what I got going here. All right, so what I have is a couple of pedals in front of this Kemper. I'm gonna duck over here and show you. An English Muff by Electro Harmonics with stock tubes in it. The tubes are probably 5 years old. It's probably time I change them because I got a bit of a buzz in it. And a radial plexi tube. If I could tell people to buy two distortion pedals, those are my picks. You know, I have tons of distortion pedals that I've picked up or fixed over the years, and I love lots of distortion pedals, but when it comes to go-to, it's those. Okay, running those straight, you know, guitar straight into that one into that one, into the plexi tube, and then I run it straight in the front. Okay, but what I've done here is something that is different than anything anybody else has done that I've seen, and I'll go over some of the questions at the end of this video, and you know who you are out there. But I'm gonna explain to you guys what I got going here, and I'll do the best I can. I'm running straight in the front of the Kemper, and I'm running into this Crown power amp, okay? It's just a small little power amp. It's kind of a piece of crap I bought in some yard sale or something somewhere. And the way I'm running it is I'm gonna have to do some crappy camera work here, but I'll show you guys something. Okay, so one side of it is going into, if you can see those yellow speakers there, and there, don't be confused with the Solo 610 over there. That mic preamp is not on and I'm not using it. But for this video, I'm using these bad boys. I built these 20 years ago or so. And the speakers in there are called focal or focal. If you're speaking to somebody from France or wherever, I don't know. So I'm running into those on one side of the power amp. And then on the other side of the power amp, I'm going into vintage 30s in that box cabinet right there. And we'll explain what's going on here in just a second. Sorry for the crappy camera work. All right, so here's what I'm doing. For the longest time when I ran into a speaker cabinet, I got this cruddy sound. It was like, so here's just a speaker cabinet. See, by turning that down, you're just gonna hear the speaker cabinet, right? So I wanna keep this volume down because I don't wanna clip that mic. Sounds kind of like milky in the center, right? Kind of like fake, right? And I don't care if you're using a DI profile or not, which is why I decided to use a DI profile. Now, if I switch the cab sim off here, which is the cabinet emulator, which would be an IR, for those of you who don't know, which is an impulse response. Now, the Kemper doesn't exactly record under an impulse response. It takes it out when you profile an amp. So if I turn the cab sim off here, which I can do, right? It sounds a little better. Does a pretty good job of taking out the cab, right? So I'm gonna step away from the camera so I can play a little harder and you don't hear that string thing in the video. I hate that. Using the distortion in this, I'm using the distortion in that pedal. So I'll pull the pedal off so that there's no confusion about the fact that we're just hearing the Kemper, right? And I got yelled at this one video, so I'll give it some distortion. Sounds that it's got that milky flavor to it. It sounds almost like a cross between compressed and muffled, right? Sounds okay. It sounds okay. All right. And so what I've done here is I've used a profile with an IR so that it's a really good sounding thing through a guitar cabinet. So I'm going to turn that back on and show you what the gist of this amp is. So I'm running straight into here, and with the focal, which would be an FR speaker, like FR just means full range, whatever, you know, and it's supposed to sound like kind of like a stereo cabinet or a studio monitor. I have that running on one side of this Crown power amp, and on the other side I have it running the 30s. So right now all you're hearing is the 30s. So I'm going to turn the 30s off, and I'll explain my madness here in a second. I'm going to turn the 30s off, and I'm going to turn just the focals on, which is basically like a studio monitor, but kind of a studio monitor on 12. Those are really good speakers. They're much lower in volume. Now they sound much better, right? I'm gonna get out of here and just check something real quick. So that is a DI profile. I'm gonna put a little bit of, take some bass out of there because they get kind of bassy, right? So it sounds good, right? Sounds pretty good. All right, so what I do here to get this sound is, I was sitting around goofing off one day and I was like, well, I can really get that crunchy goodness and that kind of crunchy tone out of the FR style setup, studio monitor, full range speaker. But when I go to a guitar cab, I kind of miss something. It gets milky sounded and all that. But it picks up that amp in the room feel. Amp in the room feel is just all of those 12-inch speakers in there all moving at one time. And you can literally, which is the reason behind this channel, you can write better when you can feel the speakers moving the air in the room. All right, so what I've done here is I've got the full-range speakers up, and it sounds killer. But it's kind of missing something. Well, watch what happens if you roll these 30s in there. The crunchy goodness, you have the tone and the feel of a tube amplifier for the most part, and you know, it does a really great job. And what I'm doing is I'm mixing them. I've only got that 412 cabinet on just a little bit, and what's happening here basically is I'm getting the feel of a tube amplifier because I'm using that guitar cabinet, but it cleans it up in the high end with that FR speaker. And the way I have this set is it's running mono. Otherwise I'd be running my delay back and forth in stereo, and it doesn't sound that good when they're that close together, at least not to me it doesn't. So I'll take the And there I didn't even have the pedal in. So I'll pull the pedal, I put the pedal in, and then, let's see. It's awful loud. Holy crap. All right, I don't want to squash that. Now that sounds good. Plexi tube now to clean. Sounds dead. The FR is out of there, right? So add the FR back. This is what's missing when you run through a guitar cabinet with the Kemper. And a lot of guys will say, well, use a DI profile, whatever. There's a DI profile, a very good one, and it just sounds better through an FR. And when I was at NAMM this year, I realized that I was listening to guys running the Kemper through an FR, and I'm like, yeah, it sounds good, but there's a difference between sound and feel, right? There's a big difference between how you feel when you play a guitar versus how it sounds. If it was all just about the sound, you know, it's kind of a silly thing to say, but the sound is very, very important. But the only way to get inspired to write something is to have it feel to the player like they're doing something. Emotional experience on the inside's coming in on the outside. Pick it up when I'm laying down. All right, so that's why for years I've been searching through digital gear. So let me run through a couple of other things here. Let me try another patch here. I'm just gonna go randomly scrap through a patch here. I don't have no idea what this is. Let me turn this down because it can blast us the hell out of here. So I'm using the cabinet in there and no delay and no reverb. I'll turn the FR off. On. How much more string separation is and cleaner it sounds? Sounds dead with just the 30s. And it does, it picks up more under your fingers when you're doing that. Now, add the 30s in, right? That's about where I like it. So there you are. I will add the pedal in. That's what's so great about the Kemper. Everything's right there on the fly, right? So you're playing a gig. I'm not sure how to solve this problem because nobody makes the kind of speaker setup that I have here. I don't even know what the hell it is. It's just something that I was dying to find. So, you know, I got kind of, you know, into a long discussion over Mr. Kemper, or with Mr. Kemper this year, Christoph, at NAMM this year, and he says, oh, it sounds just like an amp, and he's not a guitar player. And so I kind of said, you know, to me, it doesn't just exactly sound like an amp. Now, I have good ears, which is surprising as loud as I listen to crap, but I have good ears as far as, I've been doing this a long time, so I really can hear the difference in things, and I was never happy with anything else that was out there. I've played many other systems and the Axe FX and the Helix and all that stuff. And, you know, they sound okay. I honestly, one of the things I've had the best luck with is software, Scuff-Em amps, TH2 overloud or TH3 overloud now, which is just software. Go to a guy's channel called Pixie Licks. It's spelled really weird, but you'll find him on there. His name's Steve's a good guy. I met him and had some really good talks with him. He's a really good player and a sweetheart of a guy. But so I don't know how to explain kind of this rig to anybody, but man, does it work? I mean, that's talking volume. I'm worried you're hearing a string skip from my hands because it's down so low. I mean, and watch how you talk about a bedroom volume type deal, right? With still good feel. Listen to this. I mean, my voice is way over that. You'd almost have to turn it up to be in bedroom, right? Right? Come on. As I was around a couple of guys the other day that were amp guys, these guru amp guys, and they couldn't hardly tell the difference in this rig, y'all. Matter of fact, two of them couldn't tell the difference. They wouldn't guess because they couldn't tell the difference. So it's that good. So I'm gonna look into building a big cabinet. I have a huge Fender cabinet over here I got in a trade for nothing. It's got a 15 and 210s in it, and I think I'm gonna turn it into a giant FR speaker and have it to where I can EQ it the way I want, and I think it would solve a lot of my problems. So in this regard, the Kemper has so many ins and outs in this thing that you could run this type of setup on stage and then still bring it through the front of house, which is, it has outputs for that. It's just endless what you can do with the Kemper amp. People call it the Swiss Army knife, and it really is. It's a great piece of gear. Does it sound exactly like a tube amplifier? That's kind of up to you. I have a couple of really high-end amplifiers, and I kind of buy and sell them and trade them, and it's, you know, my thing. And I gotta tell you, it doesn't sound exactly like a couple of those, but if you were to go out and buy like a JCM 800 or some of the more popular amps that are out there that have been out through, you know, kind of the history of things, it sounds pretty damn good. I mean, a lot of guys like a lot of mid light. I hear that's making a speaker kind of like what we're talking about, and I don't know exactly the name of it. I can get the name of it for you guys, so that this video doesn't go too long. I'm going to switch to another patch here, or whatever you want to call it, and I'm going to go into, like, let's go into something. There's a diesel. Gotta be careful switching this thing around because it gets loud quick. Little delay. Look, the navigation of that piece of gear is just killer. Will it replace your tube amps? That's for you to decide. Play on the same channel. Just sounds dead to me. I'll turn them up so you can hear it a little better. Thank you. Kemper's a great pedal platform. That's without the FRs. In with the FRs, right about there, and I think that was right about there. So I like a little bit more high end than that. Let's do a little more. I hope that explains that rig a little bit. I hope I did a fairly decent job in that. And so this video doesn't go crazy long here. I'm gonna stop the video here and I'll be back. Don't forget to help a kid, help somebody, go out and do something. I got a really great story for something that happened to me in my life here recently. I've been gone for a long time because my hands are a mess. I broke out from some crazy chemical thing and I've been struggling with that for several months, so I apologize for being away, and hopefully it won't happen anymore. So I'm going to try to post this video today. It's Easter. Happy Easter to everybody. Know that UROC loves you, and I hope I answered all the questions about this rig. It's a fantastic thing. It's a fantastic rig. Will it replace tubes? That's for you to decide. Help somebody. Tell somebody you love them. Throw your arms around somebody. If you can't do anything else, go hand somebody a buck. Do something nice, man. Come on.